We hear enough about the placebo effect, but have you heard of nocebo effect? It's where patients experience negative symptoms after taking a dummy pill. It's further proof of the power of the mind, and to talk more about it, let's welcome psychologist Marnie Lishman to the program. Hi, Marnie.
Hello.
Why is the nocebo effect of so much interest?
Yeah, well, I think the placebo effect in itself, you know, thinking yourself well, is very fascinating stuff. But what's even more fascinating is that nocebo effect. So it's thinking yourself sick. So it's looking at, particularly in the health arena, that your negative thoughts about your symptoms or maybe a diagnosis or a prognosis, the belief in your ability to, you know, not be treated well and not get better has the ability to actually make it happen in real life.
Yeah, right. So it is interesting in that it provides some truth to the idea of visualization. So, you know, as you think negative thoughts, you're encouraging a negative outcome.
Yeah, exactly. And it's kind of the opposite of what a psychologist would teach you, you know, always, you know, visualize the positive. But I think when we get diagnosed, you know, if you go off to the doctor and you get diagnosed with something negative, it's scary, isn't it? And often we go straight to the worst case scenario.
Yeah.
But in doing that, you almost create it. You create it happening. So there's lots of research out there that's saying that, you know, even if you read the side effects, you know, on the medical insert in your medication package, you know, or say nausea, a lot of people will get nausea. If it says you're going to start itching, you'll get the itchiness, even though the medication didn't create it. It was actually the nocebo effect that did it. It was your mind.
And we know, like, our brains are so complex, aren't they?
Yeah, they're amazing. And our brains are, you know, they're built for survival. So if you're going to spook it by getting, or if your doctor's going to spook it by giving you a nasty diagnosis, it's going to turn on the stress response, which actually stops healing.
Mm-hmm.
So it actually makes things worse the way we kind of, you know, believe in what's going to happen next.
And we always hear about positive thinking, and that will provide some positive results.
Yes.
And what would you say, or how would you encourage people to create that positive thinking when they're probably in that negative space?
Yeah. Well, firstly, don't Google doctor your symptoms. I think that's my tip.
A lot of people
one.
Do, unfortunately.
Yeah, because that's always the worst case scenario, isn't it? No one writes about the good stuff. But I think, have a positive belief that you're going to get better if you're worried about stuff. But act positive as well. So, you know, put the behaviours in place to make sure that your brain knows that it needs to heal, not that it makes it worse.
All right, Marnie Lishman, we'll have to leave it there.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your insights this
Thank
afternoon.
You.
Catch you next time.
Thanks, Tat.